I can't repeat how grateful we are that you actually managed to organize the certification course despite our trouble with Turkey. Jörg and Hiro, thanks once more. The topic of today for me is to address speckle tracking, and normally I would have been speaking after tissue Doppler imaging addressed by Sasha Threshkach, but for practical reasons we had to reverse it, although it would be more logical to do it first tissue Doppler, then speckle tracking. So I have to touch somewhat on tissue Doppler just because that's the basis. Velocity measurements are the basis to start discussing deformation measurements. So I briefly touch on it, but leave the core business for Sasha. The learning objectives here are to discuss the difference between velocity measurements of tissue and deformation measurements, the techniques for myocardial deformation imaging or tissue Doppler, as I said, and speckle tracking echocardiography. That's where we will focus on now. We will just briefly show the current applications as they are being investigated and promoted for clinical use. But most importantly, at the end, we will also highlight, that's important for any new technique, the limitations. Because, you know, new techniques always make us very enthusiastic and sometimes too enthusiastic. And if we, by not recognizing the limitations, we cause errors or we make wrong decisions, that actually is worse than just not experimenting with these techniques. So it's a basic thing to consider first. So there's also historical reasons why we should first look at Doppler measurements and then go for speckle tracking. Actually, it dates back more than half a century that Doppler techniques were used to study myocardial motion. We, of course, use it for daily practice to study blood velocities, but also myocardial velocities can be traced using pulse Doppler that was explored within in the 60s. Then later the color Doppler technique, where color is coded just to show the direction of flow, but actually each color intensity corresponds with an absolute velocity. And that was an ingenious invention in the 90s, where differences in velocities were interpreted to study deformation. Next slide will clarify that. And then, because it was such a complex technology, it was just limited to a few experts that used, never caught on in clinical practice, actually, although it was promising, then there came an easier to grasp and easier technique, and that's what we refer to as speckle tracking, that enables us to study myocardial deformation as well and gets rid of the major limitations of Doppler, that is angulation, especially for transesophageal angulation or misalignment is a major limitation for the use of Doppler techniques. Speckle tracking is devoid of that limitation or overcomes that limitation. If we study the spatial motion of an object from a still position, we can measure its velocity. If we measure the displacement over time, we can measure the velocity. Look at this bar on top of the figure. We study the velocity of the beginning of the bar and of the end of the bar. And if that velocity is the same, we know how fast the bar is moving, and we also know that the bar is not changing in shape. On the bottom line, you see the same bar, but this time the velocity of the leading edge is faster, is higher than that one of the other side of the bar. So that must mean that there is deformation, that the bar is getting longer. So if one velocity is faster than the other velocity, and we study the differences in velocity, we can actually study how a tissue in between these two points is deforming, getting longer or getting shorter in one direction. And that deformation is described with an engineering team, a term, and that's strain. The definition is the deformation of an object with respect to its original shape. So the increase